Apart from factional battles within ZANU-PF, what were the main administrative challenges of being a cabinet minister in Zimbabwe?
I became a cabinet minister in 2005, 2015, sorry. I was the deputy minister in 2005. And one of the things that shocked me when I was that one of the principal directors within the ministry, within the civil service of the ministry, was a serving military general. Now, what happened in Zimbabwe between 2013 and up to now is that the military has then been placed into strategic positions within the civil service of the Zimbabwean government. And that then became something that is a major cause of concern. So you now had effectively a parallel system of government that was then happening, where these principal directors, and you will find that if you go to each and every ministry, there's a principal director who's a general, something or the other. You will find that there's this parallel system of government which is there. And that is something that is really, really problematic, in that, when these generals rise to the ranks that they are at, they would have risen, having gone through their lives taking orders and giving orders. And because they have a culture of giving orders, it becomes very, very difficult
to operate with them.
For them to listen to somebody saying, to operate with them. But more importantly, for them to listen to somebody saying, sorry, General, I don't agree because this and this and that. That is the major problem. So you have a situation where you've got serving military officers who don't take instructions from the ministers. They don't take instructions from the civil service structure. They take instructions directly from Defence Headquarters, and that problem is in all government departments and all government institutions, including within the judiciary.